أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, my name is Muhammad Aliu Yusuf, a graduate of the University of Maiduguri, Borno State. This is a class we organized purposely for the benefit of our younger students in the university, particularly my junior colleagues that are about to start their JAMB exams. So we purposely open these online tutorials for their benefit, at least to see how we can guide them in one way or the other before their exams. So this first video I uploaded is basically an introductory class. Now we want to explain some secrets or what we need to know before we write our JAMB exams. Now most of our students out there have registered these courses: biology, chemistry, and physics. Of course, English is compulsory to all students. So majority students are applying or have registered biology, chemistry, and physics. Only a few have registered mathematics. Those are the students that have the ambition of going into engineering courses or pure sciences. So the secret I would like us to outline here in my first video is, please, for the students that are writing these courses or these subjects in their JAMB exams, the first thing you do is, when you begin the exams, you'll be given all the subjects: biology, chemistry, physics, and English language. So please, what you do is, you see, we have a very limited time for you to write all these questions from the subjects. So the first secret I'll tell you is, please, as you begin your exam, the first subject you should start with is biology, because we do not have calculations in biology, and all questions carry equal marks. So please, you begin with biology. Do not start with physics. Do not even start with English language, because the questions in biology, they are very short and straightforward, and most of the questions are very cheap. So please, you begin with biology as the first subject you attempt. Now, when you finish biology, the next subject you go to is chemistry. And in chemistry, at times we do have some calculations. So please, you neglect all calculations and consider or concentrate on the theoretical aspect of the question. Please just leave calculations aside. Now, when you finish all the theoretical questions in chemistry and you left the calculations, then the next subject you go to is physics. You see, in physics, we have calculations, we have theoretical questions. So you also consider or concentrate the theoretical questions in physics. Now, when you finish the theoretical questions in physics and chemistry, and of course, you have completed the questions in biology, the next is you go to English language. Language, we have some questions that are related to comprehension. You read a passage and you answer the questions that follow. Please, when you start English questions, please do not start with the comprehension. Just leave those passages and go to simple aspects of the questions, like synonyms, antonyms, nearest and meaning. All these questions, very short, you finish them first. Even before you start the comprehension part of English, after finishing the simple questions or the short questions, then you come back to your chemistry and physics. You can do the calculations. When you are through the calculations, then you go back to your English, where you attempt the questions from the passages. So I think this is what we need to know